Hey everybody, it's Nitin. Welcome to the review of PlayStation Vita 2000. The next generation of Sony's legendary PlayStation Portable has arrived. Well, it did a couple of years ago, so yeah, this is a late review, sorry. Now I'll be going over the following areas of this system. If you want, you can go ahead and click on them right now and go ahead and skip to that area if you are interested. So first, I'm starting off by talking about hardware. It comes with a 2GHz quad-core ARM Cortex-A9 MP core processor. It has 512MB of RAM along with a 128MB of VRAM. Pretty low in my opinion, but it seems like a very powerful system when it comes to gaming. As for storage, it comes with 1GB of internal memory, but you can't expand it with Sony's Vita memory cards. They do cost a lot for what they are. On the front, you have a 5-inch LCD display with a resolution of 960x544 with a PPI of 220. It's pretty sharp. Don't worry, you're not gonna see some pixels while playing. As for the GPU, it offers a quad-core PowerVR SGX543MP4+ unit, which is pretty powerful for a handheld. As far as the sound goes, you can use 3.5mm headphones or go with the stereo speakers built into the device. The battery life is impressive too. It has a non-removable 2200mAh battery which lasts 4 to 6 hours of gaming. Let's talk about the controls. Unlike the PSP, the Vita offers dual sticks for hardcore gaming. A D-pad, a PlayStation signature button, star and select buttons below the analytic, LR shoulder buttons, a touchpad on the back which I'm not a fan of, a touchscreen on the front. All this adds up for a very promising gaming experience, but to be honest, Sony should have gone with a set of triggers rather than a touchpad, which a lot of people hate. Both sides are plain, while the top of the device has two indicator LEDs that indicate if you have notifications and power level, along with another LED which is hidden inside the hatch that you open to insert your game cartridge. If you move along, you get the volume up and down buttons. On the bottom, we have a microphone for talking to friends, 3.5mm headphone jack, and a micro USB for charging. There is a camera on the front and the back for trying and using the AR cards that come with the device. Phew, that's all for the hardware. I have covered the inside and the outside of the system. Now let's talk about the design. The design has improved quite a bit from the older version. It has a glossy finish on the front and a matte texture on the back. You can get this system in various colors. As for me, I went for the plain white. This system curves from the side, giving you a comfortable grip. On the back, Sony has provided a pad for resting your fingers on when you get tired of holding the device. But the thing is, they don't work very well. At least for me. The system looks hot with the see-through buttons and the overall finish. Not a lot to talk here, so let's move on to games. So what games does the Vita offer with all its powerful goods? Well, let's put it this way. The graphics are not a lot different from the PSP on some games, but are an improvement. Most games on the Vita are Japanese RPGs. It has a lot of ported games from the PlayStation 3 with lowered graphics. Now that says a lot if you think about it. PS3 games are great and now they are on a portable. Games like FIFA, Need for Speed Most Wanted, Minecraft, Killzone, Uncharted, Borderlands 2, and the list is huge. Console experience on the go is Vita's heart. Some games have amazing graphics that are on par with the consoles. Take Killzone as an example. The game has great lighting, shadows, blur effect, a great render distance, and much more that I can't cover in this review. Looking at the gameplay, you can tell it has power. You can also download PSP and PS1 games from the PlayStation Store and they work great. A lot of games have frame drop when there is a lot going around. The frames do recover but are a pain to deal with. They ruin the experience, but to be honest, nothing is perfect, nor it can be. Games that are not truly optimized for the Vita are ones to look out for. With console-like graphics and a 5-inch sharp display, this system is unbeatable, but it's not selling well due to the cost of producing games. Still worth the money, I'd say. The operating system is optimized for a touchscreen and it's spaced out. The app drawer only has 10 icons per page. It's not a big deal. Each opened app runs on the background and can be found to the right. On rare occasions, a game can crash, so I'd say it's not the most stable software, but it does the job. The Vita has a 0.3 megapixel camera on the front and the back. They are both the same sensors, each can take photos or a low quality video, which is only good for video chats, not something you would want to upload to YouTube. The quality from the microphone is not great either. Although you have the option to use external microphone with your headset, it's not considered that you use the camera for any use, put to chat with friends or use it for in-game purposes. I do have to admit the camera is rubbish, therefore let's move on. Now, final part of my review, the price. I got this for £125 imported from Japan, which is pretty low. The price dropped quite a bit over the years and considering what this system has to offer, it's a damn good deal. If you want PS3 experience on the go, go ahead and get the Vita. If you are looking for a 3DS, go look somewhere else. Okay, so that wraps up my review of the PlayStation Vita 2000. If you have any comments or anything I've missed out, you can go ahead and ask me in the comments below and I'll be more than happy to answer your questions. Give this video a thumbs up if it helped, and if you're looking for a channel based on the PlayStation Vita itself, because there are not a lot of them out there, well, consider my channel. I have lots of gameplays on the PlayStation Vita and a lot of accessories that are coming for the Vita that I will be taking a look at. There are loads of other games that I will be getting and it will help with the channel. If you want, you can go ahead and subscribe. Please share this video with your friends on Facebook, Twitter or Instagram or wherever you want. And other than that, I guess I'll see you next time.